For more on these political battles we've been talking about and the challenges facing Democrats, I spoke this afternoon with Senator Bernie Sanders, the ranking member of the Senate Budget Committee. And I started by asking whether he thinks an agreement will be reached to avert a government shutdown.
Well, I certainly hope there's going to be an agreement, not a short-term, but a long-term agreement. I do not and will not support billions of dollars going to a border wall at the same time as the Trump administration wants to throw 24 million people off of health insurance, cut back on education, cut back on the needs of working people. That is not something that I will support.
Senator, today at the White House, the Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross announced with regard to trade that the White House, the president, wants to slap, in essence, a tariff on Canadian lumber. You and the president often were at least in the same, or what appeared to be on the same page when it came to trade during the campaign. What do you think of this move today?
Well, I don't know enough about it to comment intelligently, but what I do know is that when we have had trade policies for decades now that have cost us millions of decent-paying jobs, as profitable corporations shut down in America and they go to China and they go to Mexico, we have to fundamentally rethink our trade policies and make them work not for the CEOs of large corporations, but for working people. So if Trump wants to develop a rational trade policies, which demands that corporations start investing in this country rather than China, that's something that we can work on. But right now, I just don't know enough about the specifics of the lumber situation.
Well, is there a specific move you'd like to see the president make on trade?
Well, as I've said, I want to see a trade policy which works for American workers. Right now, what we have seen for a very long time is large corporations shutting down plants in this country, plants that are often profitable in order to get cheap labor all over the world. And that is one of the reasons why the middle class in this country is disappearing. We have lost our manufacturing base, and it's an issue that has got to be dealt with.
In that connection, Senator, you are reintroducing legislation to increase the minimum wage to $15 an hour, I believe by 2024. This is something that's had a tough time getting through Congress in the past. You now have a Republican-controlled Senate House, a Republican White House. Is this realistic?
Of course it's realistic. It's what the American people want. It is an outrage that we have a $7.25 an hour federal minimum wage. And when we talk about why the middle class is in decline, why people are working two or three jobs, working 50, 60 hours a week, it's because wages in this country are much too low. So we've got to raise the minimum wage over a period of years to the year 2024 to $15 an hour. When people, Judy, it is not a radical idea to say that when you have massive income and wealth inequality, the very rich becoming much richer. It is not a radical idea to say that in America, if you work 40 hours a week, you should not be living in poverty. That is what the American people want, and that's what we're going to introduce.
Senator, and I think this is in connection with that. You said in an interview 2 days ago, the Democratic Party, you said this is an independent, that the Democratic Party is failing, that it needs to change. Are you saying there should be a litmus test to be a Democrat? What does one have to believe to be a Democrat?
Judy, here is the reality, and I don't think it's just me saying it. Right now, you have the Republicans controlling the White House, right-wing extremist Republicans controlling the White House, the U.S. House, the U.S. Senate, two-thirds of the governor's chairs, and in the last 8 years, Democrats have lost 900 legislative seats all over this country. That is a failed approach toward politics. So in my view, the Democrats need to do several things. Number one, Democrats need to become a 50-state party. You can't have a great party on the West Coast and the East Coast. You need to have a party in all 50 states. That is not the case right now. And that's why I've been running around the country to Republican states to galvanize people to get involved in the political process. Second of all, you need a Democratic Party which is a grassroots party, which makes decisions from the bottom on up, not just from the top on down. In my view, it is not a question of Trump having won the election. It's a question of Democrats having lost the election. Democrats need a strong progressive agenda, which says to the working class of this country, we are going to stand and fight for you. We're going to raise the minimum wage, pay equity for women. We're going to rebuild the infrastructure. We're going to guarantee health care to all people as a right. We're going to make public colleges and universities tuition free. We understand that there is enormous pain in this country. We're going to stand with working people. We're going to take on the billionaire class. We're going to take on the drug companies and the insurance companies. We're going to take on Wall Street. That's where I think the future of the Democratic Party lies.
And my question is, does that mean that some Democrats are not acceptable? For example, the special congressional election in Georgia last week, you initially did not endorse the Democrat John Ossoff.
Judy,
said he was not a progressive.
Judy, don't believe everything you read in the corporate media. John Ossoff never asked me for an endorsement, never asked me. Okay. Of course I want him to win the election, and of course I want the Democrats to gain control of the U.S. House. Just so happened, never asked me for an endorsement.
I guess the broader question is, does a Democrat have to toe a certain line? You said Democrats have to do well in red states. So, for example, a Heidi Heitkamp in North Dakota, Joe Manchin in West Virginia. Well, are these Democrats you consider under the tent that you'd like to see, under the umbrella of the Democratic...
Those decisions are going to be made by the people in North Dakota, where I think Heidi is quite popular, be made by the people in West Virginia. It is not my job to tell the people in 435 congressional districts or in 50 states who they should be supporting. What a grassroots party is about is people getting excited, getting involved in the local political process, saying we want her to run for office, we want him to run for office, and we're going to get involved and make sure that he or she wins. That's what I think the future of the Democratic Party is. Not a few people in Washington saying, sorry, no good. Or that's okay.
So you're saying it's all right with you that the Democratic Party has elected members who, for example, disagree with you on trade, who may disagree with you on the corporate tax rate, on issues like abortion.
Right. Look, you know, this is America. You know, between you and me, Judy, I would love it if everybody in America agreed with me on every issue. I can't get my wife to agree with me on every issue, let alone the American people. It's called democracy. That's what it's about. So I think, you know, I have supported candidates whose views are very different than mine on the need to break up Wall Street banks, on the war in Iraq, on trade issues. Of course I have supported those people. My hope is that we're going to see, and I believe it is the case, we're going to see more and more strong progressives running for office. That is my hope. That is my desire. But that is up to, that decision is going to be made by people in 50 states and 435 congressional districts.
Senator Bernie Sanders, very good to talk with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Judy.